Hello and welcome to another how-to video. Now on this one, which I've had a request for, is on the shed building that you can see here in front of you, which is the main loco shed of Kilbreck TMD here. I've installed some more floodlighting, and these are actually on the building themselves. So there's two floodlights on this end of the building, and there's a single floodlight on the other side. And it's in line with the other smaller shed that also has the floodlighting. So in this video we're going to have a look at how you install the floodlights. So before we actually go on to the how-to part, we're just going to cover the wiring. You'll need a 12 volt transformer, and you can see here I've actually got two plugged in here. One is for the lighting on the lower level, and the other one is for the lighting on the upper main part of the layout. So on this diagram here, we'll now show you how this lighting kit connects to the mains. So this thing here is the transformer. The floodlights will run from anything from 3 volts up to 12 volts. If you're using a 3 volt supply, you don't need to use a resistor. The kit comes with 6 resistors, and these are supplied in the kit, so it's using 1 resistor per floodlight, but that is on the 12 volt supply. If you're using 3 volt, you don't have to use the resistor. So for wiring up one, it's just a case of running your red and black wire straight back to your transformer. Now the transformer I've got has a short lead with a jack plug on, and included with it is a fly lead, so has the other half of the jack plug, so that would plug into the other half of the jack plug on here. And on the other end you have shot block, so somewhere on here you would put the shot block like so. And it's a case of just stripping the end of the red wire, inserting it into the chop block, and tightening up the screw to connect up. And it's the same with the black wire. And that's that. But if you're wanting to add more floodlights, it's just a case of adding another floodlight and running your red wire and your black wire into the relevant parts of the chop block as shown. So as you can see in this diagram here, we have two, so the two red wires, you'd either join it sort of here or put another chop block in here and just a short little wire back to there. If you're using a 12 volt transformer, then obviously you need to use the resistors, so somewhere between the connector block and the floodlights you need to put a resistor in. So the resistor goes in on the red wire, so one will go there and the other one will go there. Now you can either solder these onto the red wire, or you could use a chop block, and then in this case of just running your red wire back to the chop block here, and with the other red wire from the other resistor again back to the chop block. And you just repeat this for the other four floodlights that you are fitting into here. The one thing I would recommend if you are soldering the resistors onto the red wire is to use some heat shrink tubing. So it's just a case of cutting it to length, sliding it over the resistor and the solder joint, and then just holding the soldering iron near it just to shrink it down onto the resistor. Now in my case, I'll just turn the diagram over, I have what's known as a power bus, like a ring main running from the transformer, which is these two wires running around the layout, and at various points using a chock block connector is taking two wires from the ring main, run up through the baseboard up to the lighting on the main part of the layout. So for example, I've tapped into the lighting that's already fitted in the shed. So you can see here the ring main, the red positive wire and the black negative wire that connect onto the ring main running up into the centre of the shed. So you've got to imagine you're inside the shed looking up at the roof. So this is two strip lights with LEDs on. So the two wires run up into the centre and then basically run out from the solder joint to the two LED lighting strips. So rather than running an extra two wires down to the ring main, the power bus, what I've done is I've tapped into the two wires that are feeding the two lighting strips inside the shed. You'll see this shortly as we go through on the how-to, stage by stage. So basically, where the solder joint is, where the two wires from the lighting strips join the wire feeding in from the power bus, I've added the red wire that then splits into two to feed both the floodlights, and the same again with the black wire. On the actual shed itself, as I said before, I've got three LEDs, so you can imagine there's like just another set of two wires running and joining onto here. And again, with the resistors, we fitted the resistors somewhere about on this section here before they actually join the main feed going up. As you'll see in the part of the video to follow after this, how it's done stage by stage. But with the drawing here, this is how I've tried to keep it as simple as possible for you to understand.